Hello dear patients, today we are going to review the case of healing of ulcer on the leg. A woman came to see us, she had removal done. We are not going to discuss what was removed, as a result of which an ulcer developed. Indeed, when quite large elements are removed, be it a wart or some keratosis, etc., using a radio wave method, laser, etc., then quite often a large defect is formed. When a crust is removed or when it is not removed, then quite a significant skin defect is formed, as in our case. That is basically an ulcer after the removal of neoplasm. It usually oozes a little, as in our case. What needs to be done? First of all, healing has to be stimulated. What preparations were used in this case and what was done? First of all, there was no pus here. Therefore, there is no global sense in prescribing antibiotics here, as there is no pus, no reddening, no tenderness. So stimulators of healing have to be prescribed here: intravenous azone, polyoxidonium, vitamin therapy, B1, B6 intramuscularly, calcium gluconate. So these medications were prescribed. What was prescribed internally? This was methyluracil tablets. What was prescribed externally? Cold packs with fluorosilin were prescribed for external use. This A disinfected this wound. B, it gradually decreased an active inflow of blood there. It decreased inflammation. This altogether led to gradual healing of ulcer and significant improvement, literally on third, fourth days of treatment. Therefore, first of all, it is always necessary to use a complex approach. Secondly, if ulcer gets wet, then under no circumstances a lot of ointments should be put there, because this often harms such ulcers that heal. Thirdly, it has to be remembered that wet should be moistened. This is a law of skin diseases. Therefore, soaking therapy was prescribed here. Fourthly, antibiotics are not always required if there is no pus, no indications for it. Of course, if there is pus, then a culture test has to be done for that. That is for bacteria that induce this. First, an empirical antibiotic has to be prescribed, then it has to be chosen correctly. Third and the main thing, the body has to be stimulated for active healing. Intravenous heptral can also be added here, as it works well. Such preparations have to be added during treatment of ill healing ulcers. So if you have any defects that do not heal for a long time, you can get a consultation of dermatologists and venereologists of paid medical center of dermatovenerologic dispensary in Moscow for assessment and effective prescription of treatment after such removals. We occasionally have people coming to us after removal of condylomas acuminatus, when there are focuses on quite large areas. Sometimes people come with a full row of condylomas acuminatus and indeed they do not heal well. Therefore, we recommend our patients to come for re-evaluations after removal, or if it does not heal well, then it's mandatory to come, because this process cannot be left unattended, as it may lead to other complications. If it is necessary to deal with different consequences of removals, suppurations and for performance of removal, you can consult venereologists, urologists and dermatologists of our paid medical center of dermatovenerologic dispensary in Moscow. We have experienced specialists who work with such problems. We are waiting for you in our clinic.